In 38 years, since the first outbreak, Ebola has killed at the most 1,500 people. That's like 30, 40 a year. So it was not a public health problem. It's only now that this has become really a big, big issue.
It's also been a developing world problem.
Yes.
Do you think that has been part of the problem, that there isn't the money to drive the investment in research?
Well, there are days that I think, you know, it took 1,000 Africans to die and two Americans who had to be repatriated before a public health emergency was declared. I mean, it's along the same lines, you know.
Which brings us to one of the recent developments, that a man has, for the first time, been diagnosed in the United States with Ebola. He had travelled from Liberia, but he'd been in the United States, moving around for 10 days. What's the chance that he has infected other people?
Well, first of all, this is going to happen again. That's why it's so vital that in West Africa we bring this epidemic under control, because otherwise it will be a continuous source of infections for any other country in the world. Now, as long as this man was asymptomatic, was not ill, there's no danger about it. I mean, I said in one interview I would be happy to sit next to someone with Ebola in the tube as long as that person is, you know, is not ill. So it'll depend now when this man got ill, or a woman, it's a person, who cared for that person, did the person go to another hospital and so on. These are the people I would be worried about. Okay.